Hi, I'm Daniel Hunt. I'm a certified legal specialist in estate planning, trust, and probate law. Most of the cases I handle these days involve trust and estate litigation. This type of litigation usually involves trust beneficiaries taking legal action against a trustee. If you're a beneficiary, wondering if you should invest time and money to pursue legal action against a bad trustee, you probably want to know if you have a case. In this video, I'm going to share under what circumstances a beneficiary may want to consider suing a trustee. Generally, suits against trustees tend to be brought by trust beneficiaries who want to accomplish one or more of these objectives. First, remove a trustee and replace them with a more appropriate person. Second, prompt a trustee to distribute trust assets and complete the trust administration. Third, recover trust funds that the trustee has misappropriated. Fourth, obtain a copy of the trust or other trust-related information that has been withheld, like tax returns and accounting or trust assets. Fifth, obtain an interpretation of an ambiguous trust term and establish the settlor's intent. Sixth, propose that the trust instrument was a product of fraud, duress, or undue influence. If you're wondering if your case is legitimate, here are six common reasons lawsuits have been successfully brought against a trustee. First, breach of trust. This means that the trustee is administering the trust in a manner that violates the terms of the trust instrument. For example, if the trust directed that a beneficiary's distribution was to be paid outright, but the trustee is attempting to hold those funds in trust, meaning to manage them on behalf of the beneficiary, that would be a breach of trust.
Tell me the truth, okay? Because there's been a lot of lying in this family.
And a lot of love.
Second, breach of a fiduciary duty. A trustee has numerous duties in their role under the California Probate Code. A violation of these duties is called a breach of fiduciary duty. For example, a trustee who favors one beneficiary, or themselves, if they're also a beneficiary, over another has violated the duty to deal impartially with beneficiaries.
I love all my children equally. I don't care for Joe.
Third, misappropriation of trust funds. This means the trustee has been paying for things that don't directly benefit the trust. For example, the trustee has been using trust funds to purchase themselves designer handbags or a new Lexus. That would be a misappropriation of trust funds.
Remember we had that conversation about trying to cut back on things that aren't necessities?
Like it was yesterday.
It was this morning, and now I hear that you've hired a crew for the yacht. I'm selling that yacht.
Fourth, mismanagement of trust funds. This means the trustee is failing to make trust property productive or incurring economic waste. If the trustee fails to address poorly performing trust investments, that is an example of mismanaging trust funds.
I mean, it's one banana, Michael. What could it cost? $10?
Fifth, malfeasance. This means the trustee has acted in bad faith or done something that is purposely injurious to the beneficiary. An example of malfeasance could be a trustee who donates in a beneficiary's name to a political organization that they oppose. Yes, we've seen this happen in real life.
It's not fair to Buster. He's a nervous wreck right now. He's going into the army, for God's sake.
You volunteered him.
I knew you were going to throw that in my face.
Sixth, fraud. Fraud means that the trustee has misrepresented a material fact intending to mislead or deprive. For example, a trustee is committing fraud if they lie to a trust beneficiary and tell them that no trust exists or that no trust assets exist.
I didn't even know that we had a cabin.
Next, let's be clear on a couple of not so good reasons to sue a trustee. Your case probably won't get very far in some of the following situations. The settlor disinherited you from the estate or left you less than other beneficiaries in a properly executed estate plan. While it may not feel fair to be disinherited or get less than others, you can't sue anyone over this decision unless the trust was a product of fraud, duress, or undue influence. Another way might be the trustee took a reasonable trustee's fee, which decreased the amount of your inheritance. Trustees are entitled to reasonable compensation for the work they perform in this role. In the next video, part 2, we'll walk you through the basic steps of trust litigation. If you have any questions about trust and estate litigation, feel free to contact our office. Thanks.
We hope you found this video helpful, and if you'd like more information on estate planning or our law firm, you can check us out on Facebook, Twitter, or our website that are listed below. If you'd like to contact us, you can do so at 916-488-9788 or at our email info@dhtrustlaw.com. Thanks.